Hi friends, welcome back to biology exam. Today we are going to discuss about the difference between MHC class 1 and MHC class 2 complexes. First of all, starting with the definition. MHCs or HLA complex consists of genes encoding cell surface glycoproteins that are essential for antigen presentation to T cells and also responsible for graft rejection. These complexes, in humans, it is called as HLAs or human leukocyte antigen complex. And the compatibility of MHC protein of donor and recipient will determine the success of organ transplantation. Difference number one, this is a nucleated cell. MHC class 1 is present in all nucleated cells. In the case of RBC, nucleus is absent, therefore MHC class 1 receptor is absent. In the case of MHC class 2, this is present on antigen-presenting cells like B cells, macrophages, dendritic cells, etc. Let us take the example of B cell. B cell is having a receptor called MHC class 2. As it is a nucleated cell, it will be also having MHC class 1 receptor. Of course, there will be a B cell receptor that will specifically bind to an antigen. Other antigen-presenting cells include macrophages, dendritic cells, etc. Difference number 2. This is regarding with the structure of MHC class 1. MHC class 1, as we mentioned, it's a receptor. It's a heterodimer consisting of two polypeptide chains, an alpha chain and a small beta chain. Alpha chain consists of a cytoplasmic region, a transmembrane region, and there is an extracellular region that is actually responsible for binding with antigenic peptide. In the extracellular domain, there is alpha 1, alpha 2, and alpha 3 region. This alpha 2 and alpha 3 region is constant, whereas alpha 1 region is a variable region that is responsible for antigenic binding. And this beta 2 chain, it's very small. In MHC class 1, it is called as beta 2 microglobulin. Whereas in the case of MHC class 2, there are two peptide chains, alpha chain and beta chain, but both are of almost identical length. This alpha 1 region and beta 1 region at the amino terminal is a variable region that is responsible for binding with antigenic peptide. Difference number 3, this is regarding the interaction of MHCs with other immune cells. MHC class 1 interacts mainly with cytotoxic T cells that is responsible for cell-mediated immunity. As we mentioned, MHC class 1 is present on nucleated cells. Suppose this is a virus. Once inside the cell, these viruses is degraded into antigenic peptides. And these are presented, degraded particles are presented on MHC class 1. And this can be recognized by T cytotoxic cells. T cytotoxic cell is having a receptor which is called as CD8 receptor that can recognize MHC class 1 bound antigenic peptide. And this will actually trigger the proliferation of TC cells. And that is actually involved in cell mediated immunity. Whereas in the case of MHC class 2, MHC class 1 receptor is already there in a B cell like antigen presenting cell. Suppose this is a virus. Viral particles are degraded inside the cell and that is presented on MHC class 2 receptor. Here, T helper cells can recognize an antigenic peptide that is bound to MHC class 2 receptor. This T cell has a receptor which is a CD4 receptor that can recognize MHC class 2 bound antigenic peptide. When antigenic peptides are bound on MHC class 2, can activate T helper cells. Difference number 4. Alpha chain is coded on MHC locus of chromosome 6, whereas beta chain is encoded on chromosome 15. In the case of MHC class 2, both chains are coded on MHC locus of chromosome 6. Difference number 5. MHC class 1 is encoded by HLA AP and HLA C genes located on the respective chromosomes, whereas MHC class 2 genes are encoded by HLA-D genes. Difference number 6, MHC class 1 is responsible for graft rejection and also clearance of endogenous antigens. The TC cells will clear out all these infected cells by creating pores on the membrane by perforins, and also there is a digestive enzyme which is called as granzymes that will ultimately eliminate these cells from the system so that the surrounding cells are protected. Whereas MHC class 2 is responsible for graft rejection and clearance of exogenous antigens like bacterial toxins, viral toxins, etc. or infectious pathogenic toxins that will be cleared out by MHC class 2 in association with T helper cells. The importance of MHCs is each individual has specific MHC or HLA proteins just like DNA fingerprints. And this will help the immune system to distinguish its own cells from foreign cells. This is the reason why transplant rejection occurs as the immune system recognizes the transplant cells as foreign and initiating an immune response just like a foreign particle or antigen leading to graft rejection. So the compatibility of MHC proteins between the donor and recipient is very essential for successful organ transplantation. That is why doctors often say if the organ is from genetically closer relative, then the chance of success is more. Hope you got the point. You are with biologyexamsory.com. Thank you so much for your support. If you like this video, please subscribe, share and like.